bio, Doug. I'm having a very good time. And it's been a while since I've inked dice, so trying to get the hang of it and remember how I do this. So that sucks as a pain in the butt. Yeah, I haven't tried inking these with crayon yet. I've been thinking about it, but since these are all kind of like, well, these are just random ones, like factory seconds that I got. So you see the indent in the dice isn't very deep. So it's almost like when you're inking it, it's almost the ink is laying directly on the surface. So it's hard to get the paint pen in the groove. Like you see with this 8 side here, it's a little nick on it. So these are all factory seconds, so these aren't the best qualities. Yeah, this is D12 on the 5 here. If you can see that, it has a little nick on it. But this one in particular, the grooves aren't very deep, so it's hard to get in there. Oh yeah, this one's pretty bad. And usually you can clean them up. I usually just take an emery board. Just a plastic one is fine to smooth out any hard edges. I might do that with this one. So that 5 came out pretty well, but you can see that looks like where it was in the mold and they clipped it. So just a little bit of a raise up there, and it looks like there's a little circle in the 5. It's hard to see, but I mean, none of these are going to be perfect, and this is just, I'm just practicing, because I'll do a stream of a giveaway that I participated in for the, well, thank you. I'm trying my best with thinking. Can't remember what his name was, but Dan did a donation last Friday night for the Stink Razor for Stink Rat Streams Twitter handle. A fundraiser for that. I played a D&D game, and I offered if we had gotten $100 donation in our stream that I would ink a set of dice. So I contacted him, found out what he wanted, and now I'm just practicing, because I'll do a stream for his. I'm liking how this one turned out. It's kind of hard to see. You can see the yellow on the light blue. And again, these are like factory seconds, so they're not perfect. Like you can see with these two sides, they look good, but this side is really discolored. It almost looks yellowish compared to the two. And it's not from the ink on that I laid down. It's just a discoloration in the dye itself. So that's okay. I'm gonna redo that one. The ones are always difficult. But the way the ones are designed, I wonder if there's a one on one of these. You can see that might not be a good one. The ones don't have a lot of depth to them, and they're very small and thin, so it's hard to ink the ones. That one's okay. We'll go back to that one. The numbers got smudged, so I just have a paper towel sprayed with some Goo Gone spray. Takes off the ink before it dries pretty quickly, and the ink that I'm getting on my desk. But then it leaves it kind of greasy, so if you try to lay down ink right away after it, it's gonna smudge, so you gotta kind of let it dry. And if your fingers have the Goo Gone residue on them too, they'll smudge the numbers. So you kind of got to be careful about that. So I got a wet paper towel and a dry one. I think this one's okay. This one turned out pretty well. I'll file down this edge. This one looks pretty good. I got to redo the 2 and the 8. Let's see if we can tackle this 6 again on here. This one's not coming out too great. Ink is kind of smudgy. I'm gonna leave that side alone so it just dries, because it came out pretty well. Focus. Focus, focus. There you go. That's what I gotta tell myself when I study. Focus, focus, focus. And then come out too bad. I'll probably spray some Goo Gone on like a Q-tip after these are dry and clean up some of these edges, and just like the tiny little bit off the number. But sometimes that's an advantage with having a little bit longer nails. You can kind of just scrape it off, but that one's a little bit too close. Debating. I started inking this one. I took all the ink off because I think it was this 8 was really smudged. So I'll try and see if I can redo that one with this lighter blue. Trying to figure out why the chat's not popping up on the stream. But, oh well. I mean, this is my first time trying to use OBS. And I'll, if I continue doing these inking streams, I'll change it up a little bit, but, yeah, it definitely takes some pretty still hands. Even sometimes I mess it up, like you move a little bit and you just like run off the number and you gotta clean it all off, but, I hope this one isn't dead. Yeah, oops. It's just a little bit coming out, but oh well. Wonder if I can get this white to work. I think this white would look really nice on here. Oh, it pops up then disappears for a while? Huh. I will try to see. I'll play around with it and then see why it's doing that. Is there even anything coming out of here? Ow, that hurts. Don't do that on your finger. That doesn't feel good. Come out. Ooh. I just saw like a flick of white shoot out somewhere. And I don't know where I went. I don't know if I was imagining that or not. Well, I'll figure out what that was later. Let's see if this white ink will work. Yes. And I messed up the two already. Way to go. Way to go. Okay. It kind of lays on there really nicely. I play with OBS a little bit. I find it less than intuitive. Yeah. I was told too that it's changed a lot. And since I'm not doing like on screen streaming, like I'm not streaming what's on my screen, they changed like a lot of the, I think, layouts and stuff like that. So. Or, like, how they. I don't know. I've never really tried to stream much before. So. I hate these ones. God damn it. Gruber said number one is the best, obviously. Didn't know anything about trying to ink dice. Number one is the worst. Well, that still looks like poop. I'm making it worse. God damn it. Just lay on beautifully.
was okay.
So I just touched the side that I inked. Ow. These hurt. My fingers. There needs to be other, more dice companies that come with uninked dice so you can ink them yourselves besides these Game Science ones. Even though Game Science is my favorite, these edges. Man, these edges are killing me. Hurts. Ow. Gonna get dents in my fingertips. Let that dry. That's a pretty decent one. Try and get it. What was the one uninked die that you had, O-Dog? Maybe you should start inking. Try to see if you can get just a crayon or a marker. Try and ink that baby up. Just take all of that 8 off. Just start over. Sometimes it's just better to start it over. Ow. My fingertips. That's what I should title the stream. Ow, my fingertips. Oh, that looks like poop. Ow. Ow. See that? Ooh, 1981. Yeah, ouch. That's what I was saying. Now my fingertips. Time is it? 9 o'clock. Okay. Okay, let's just let that dry. Let's go back to this. Okay. Little bit of leftover blue from my shooting game first time, but it just comes right off. Okay. That looks kind of weird. I messed that up, so I'm just gonna start over. Stop messing it up. Oh my god. Got stuck to my finger. Okay. So it looks pretty good. Clean up the surfaces and the edges. Same thing with this one, there's a little bit of green on the corner of that one. Probably file down where that five is, where they clipped it from the mold. This one I think came out the best. And this one, just a pain in my butt. Might have to go over it a second time once this dries more. I usually like to let them sit for about at least 24 hours before I ink them again, because they're still kind of, just so it sets. Yeah, it's hard to see this. It's supposed to be like really like light blue. I don't know if the color is like picking it up really well. But yeah, it really stands out. That's what I like about it. Can't lay my hand. Focus. 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 Okay. Doesn't want to focus. That's fine. Okay. Yeah. There you go. Yeah. These are the other ones I have. I have a lot of D12s. I don't know why. I got all these D12s that I can ink. Like, these are some yellowish ones. Here's just a white one. Here's like another really off blue, similar to this one. And then I have this really nice blue, this is D20, and this brown D4. So I will probably do those another time, but I think these five are good for now. I'll let them dry. This one I tried. No, not that one. Oh, this is just another. Just an orange D12, but a big one compared to this D12. It's a lot bigger. Now, this one I tried to use this red marker on here, because my friend Daquin said he really liked Dragon Ball Z, and so this D12 reminded me of like the ball or whatever. I don't know. Well, I didn't watch Dragon Ball Z, so I don't know what it is. But I know it's like a red. It's like an orange ball, and it's got like red stars on it, I think. But the red doesn't really show up on this orange. And it's really hard to see. So I'm thinking I'll just redo it in black. Or if there's a way I could lay it with white and then red. But again, these numbers aren't really, the indents aren't very deep. So I don't think that would work. So maybe if I clean this one up, maybe I could try using crayon or like a different thinner paint marker, because these are this one, this list the deco color, but I think these are all the extra fine. Why isn't it saying on these? Just say on here somewhere. I'm going crazy. No, that's Spanish. I can't read that. Well, these are all the thinnest points for these markers. Anything thicker would not fit in the indents of these. So, whenever I get paint markers, they have to be this really thin tips. Yeah, if I use the blue, I try to use this blue on this one originally, and it turned out pretty well and it looked kind of nice. I messed up the D8, which is why I messed up the 8, so I wanted to redo it, so I just laid it in white. But maybe I might try and do this one in one of the blues. That might look pretty nice. But yep. So oh yeah, I'll let these ones dry. I'll try and take the rest of the ink off this one and try and lay it in blue. Or maybe I might try crayon on it and see how well I can figure out crayon. I don't know. I heard like the more waxy the crayon, the better it is. So using Crayola wouldn't be the best because they're not soft crayons. But if I heard like a Rosa Art crayons work well, so I just gotta find really soft crayons. So I'll figure out how to do that. But I think I'm gonna go. Ooh, I gotta get ready for bed because I have class in the morning. So I think I'm gonna just end the stream here. Thanks for coming and hanging out and watching me play with my dice and chatting. And I'll make more of an announcement when I plan on doing one of these. This was just kind of a test. I'll probably ink some more of these before I do the stream of inking the winner's dice. So I don't know, if people like these then I'll keep doing them if I get more viewers and stuff like that. But otherwise, have a good night, have a good day tomorrow, and I will talk to you later. Bye.